What improvement, if any, did they tell you?
Huh?
Nash,
he didn't say anything yet. I didn't ask. I should have asked him to get an update. I don't know. But game time decision, I guess. Doubtful, probably. You know, something like that. It's not completely out of the woods, but we want to be a little cautious with it.
And as for Kobe, you said out of the woods. Is he kind of?
No, I think he's ready to go.
Surprise you that they've been able to make a run here late in the season?
Anytime you got in the whiskey, and Rick Carlisle does a great job. And they've gotten a lot of veteran players. They know how to play. Sean Marion, Elton Brand, OJ Mayo, Vince Carter. They got a lot of guys. They're just new, and it took them a while to get it going. And Dirk was hurt all year. When that happens, and he's underneath what he normally gives you, he's going to struggle a little bit. But they're a dangerous team right now.
With eight games left, every team, every game means something. But sure this does. One, obviously, you have a little bit more.
I don't know how this is more important than one Memphis. I mean, we got to win them all, and you know, that starts tomorrow.
What's the significance for you of Shaq's personal
career? Well, it's just great for him. He was fun to coach when we were in Phoenix with him, and bigger than life. And, you guys know it better than I do, but he was good for us. And so happy for him. And, his life goes on, and he gets retired. It's good for him.
What memories stick out to you the most when you
Shaq, just him running around the locker room crazy. Just funny. Him driving the big semi-trailer cab that blowing his horn all over the place. He just, you know, does everything at a grand scale. And he was, like I said, he was fun to be with. It was good.
And when you look at the totality of his career, I mean, what do you
One of the best ever. You know, you talk about one of the best big men ever. How many rings were it? Four or something like that?
Yeah.
Just good. Just really good. Just changed basketball.
It's in how,
what
way?
Well, it's just everything you do, you're preparing against his team. You talk about Shaq 90% of the time. Prepare how to not leave his body. When you're going to double team, or you're going to hack him, or you're going to do this, or you're going to do that. There's very few guys you spend the whole scouting meeting talking about. He's one of those guys.
You have Pau, Jameson, and Earl on Nowitzki?
At the same time.
that's the guys.
I think the league let us put three on him.
It goes through an eight.
No, who did I say? You said Pau, Jameson, and Earl. Yeah, that's
not rotating that's whatever right. Seems to be working.
Yeah, we'll see. Yeah. I mean, Pau's going to do the most of the work because he's going to play most of the minutes, and then Earl will have to play the rest. If we get down to Antoine doing it, then he'll have to go.
How has Pau been coming around now?
Good. I thought he had a good game last night. His foot's still bothering him, and I think his game shape is getting better, but his timing is getting better. He's playing better. Although you see him struggling sometimes with his wind and his foot, but his timing is getting a lot better.
Is it a good idea then to bring him back as early as you did instead of waiting just to get his wind back and get him ready?
Well, he had to, otherwise the season would be lost. I mean, we could, now with Matt out, it really puts a big strain on us. So, he had to do it.
Hi, I'm Mike Dunleavy, and you're watching LakersNation.com.
Hey, I'm Julius Erving. You're watching LakersNation.com.
Hey, I'm Tim Brown, and you're watching LakersNation.com.
I'm Jalen Rose. Where's Magic Johnson? You're watching LakersNation.com.